Welcome back, class 12th. In this lecture, in the previous lectures, we have discussed about this chapter, optical instrument. Especially, we have discussed about the simple microscope, compound microscope, and astronomical telescope. I told you that astronomical telescope is of two types. One is refracting type, second is reflecting type. Before I'm going to the next topic, means reflecting type telescope, I want to discuss about the refracting type telescope. In this refracting type telescope, the object which is at infinity, means at very far distance, the rays are coming from that to this objective lens. This objective lens has large focal length than this eyepiece lens. And then finally you get a magnified image here. I'm not talking about that. The main point I want to discuss that in this astronomical telescope refracting type, the objective and the eyepiece both are having different focal lengths. And this telescope has magnifying power. Just you can see here. This telescope has magnifying power M is equal to FO upon FE. Negative sign is there. M is equal to minus FO upon FE. This shows that the magnifying power of this astronomical telescope refracting type can be increased by how? Means I want to increase its magnifying power. With this equation you can see M is equal to minus FO upon FE. Means we can change the focal lengths only. We can't do anything else. See the diagram also. In the diagram, you can't change anything to increase the magnifying power. One thing that we can change, which is the focal length of the lenses. So, FO upon FE. In the numerator, F is there. FE must be smaller as possible. And in the numerator, that is FO. FO must be of larger and a larger size. So see the diagram again in this size. In this diagram, you can see the size of the objective is already larger than the eyepiece. Just to increase the magnifying power. If you want to further magnify, the image, means we want the larger size of image of the celestial bodies, means closer and closer image. For example, as I said, you are at the terrace of your house and you are able to see the surface of moon. You are able to see the moon and you can feel the surface of moon. But can you see clearly the surface of moon? No. If you are using this telescope, you can. But there is a problem in this telescope. What is the problem? This is of very high cost. Why? Because this objective, whatever it is having the focal length, is larger than the eyepiece. If you want to magnify, we have to make the larger and larger size of this objective lens. The larger and larger size of objective lens means what? The more and more material that you are going to use. The more and more material if you are using means the larger and larger size, more and more material means the cost of this telescope goes on increasing. And we want to make this telescope in a cheaper cost, in very low cost. How to do that? For that, we are going to replace this objective. How to replace? We will replace this lens with mirror. In my last lecture, when I was explaining about the refracting type telescope, I told you that we will replace this lens by mirror. But I am revealing the word that mirror will not be simple mirror, that will be a spherical mirror, concave spherical mirror. Means instead of this lens, objective lens, which is going to be of very large size, instead of that
we can use the mirror. Benefits are, first, that is very of low cost in comparison of lens. Lens will become very fragile in comparison to the mirror. And two more topics are there which is not in your syllabus now. The spherical and the chromatic aberration. I'm not going to deep in this topic, the spherical and the chromatic aberration. Just I want to explain you a little bit in a short about the chromatic aberration. When the lens focuses a white light at a certain point, if the image is sharp white, means the lens is free from the chromatic aberration. But a lens cannot produce an image without any aberration. Aberration means the difference in the image as object. I'm simply saying the white object will not be formed white using lens. It will give some colors. This is called chromatic aberration. This is not in your syllabus. So these are the points which is going to be removed by using what? A spherical mirror. Now again, what we are going to do in this telescope, we are going to replace this objective lens with a concave spherical mirror. Using that, many benefits are there. The cost will be low, the chromatic and the spherical aberration will be removed, and many more points are there. Now how to do this? Just see. Suppose there is a light coming from reflected light, means if you are seeing any object, this is why. Suppose if you are watching me, it means the lights are falling on my body and then reflects to the lens of the camera, then you are able to see. If I'm not reflecting the light, means you will not be able to see, like my hair. It is absorbing all the lights, so that's black. If you are seeing any object white, means it reflects all the light. Same way, suppose there is any object in this direction. And that object, like you can take example, Saturn. So the lights are reflected from Saturn toward this Earth. And I want to receive the rays. I want to see the Saturn. How to see? Same thing, we are going to use telescope. But which telescope? Reflecting time. How it will work? Consider this. My hand, this one, is what? The concave spherical mirror. So the light which is coming from the Saturn, that's reflected light from the sun, will be received by this mirror. After reflection, this reflected light will go somewhere in this direction. Now, if I want to see the image of that Saturn, so we have to sit in this direction, means we have to sit above the mirror, spherical mirror. So suppose you are using a house size of, a size of house type, a spherical mirror, so you have to sit above the house. That's a little bit difficult. To avoid that, we will use a spherical mirror like this. And after this, we will place a mirror here. What will happen? The reflected light will receive by this plane mirror. And this plane mirror will reflect the light in the downward side. And if the light is going downward, so what will we have? The next part of the telescope. What is next part? Next part means the first part was of objective lens. The second part is of eyepiece lens. The first part is over. Of the objective, instead of objective lens we are using spherical mirror. The first part is over. Now this reflected light will go down. The next part stands for the eyepiece lens. We will use the eyepiece lens in such a way, we will position this eyepiece lens in such a way that the reflected light coming from this mirror is going to be form an image at the focus of the eyepiece. Then what will happen? The image will be found at infinity. And we know that at infinity the image is found very highly magnified. So let's see in detail what is going on right now about the construction of the astronomical type telescope. Let's see in the detail each and every step of ray diagram.
So here starting the step-by-step formation of the images, means you can say the construction of the astronomical telescope. For that, let AB is any celestial body,
and from that the rays are going towards this spherical mirror, and this spherical mirror will act as a objective. Then the mirror reflects the light towards the principal axis of this mirror. After reflection from the spherical mirror, the rays are moving towards the plane mirror and then further reflected from that mirror. When the rays are reflected from the mirror, then they meet at a point B dash and they are forming the image A dash B dash. As you can see, one virtual image is forming A double dash B double dash behind the plane mirror. But these rays goes on further towards what? The eyepiece lens. The eyepiece lens is presented there, which bends the ray toward the principal axis again. Then they are retrieved, means received by the means observer to see the formation of image. And in this way, we can see a highly magnified image which is formed at infinity. Now, let's see in the papers to find the magnifying power of this image. Magnifying power of this instrument means astronomical telescope. Let's start the astronomical telescope reflecting type. For that, let's consider one object here and a mirror. The principal axis of the concave mirror, the spherical concave mirror. This mirror will act as an objective. And now let's draw the celestial object. We are considering this AB is our celestial object. And now let's draw the incident rays. Two rays coming parallel means the object is at infinity. So rays are coming parallel to the mirror. And see what is happening after reflection. I'm considering that this is the only setup for as an astronomical telescope. The image of the celestial object is obtained here. Let's see what is happening right now. I'm using a pencil because these rays are not really going there. We are going to use a mirror somewhere here. So suppose there is nothing like mirror and eyepiece. So the image which is coming from, the rays which is coming from infinity, they are coming parallel. After reflection, they will meet at focus. So it means this point, this one, is what? The focus of what? This mirror. And this mirror I am considering as objective. So this point will be some like focus of the objective. Now I am going to place mirror and making this part only real, and this is as dotted ray. So you can see here I have placed one mirror, plane mirror. And now see, this mirror blocks all the rays further. So we can say the virtual image means the virtual position by these rays, the virtual image is found A dash B dash at the focus. But as the mirror is here, plane mirror, so light will reflect in this direction. Let's see. So now you can see the one ray reflected from the mirror in this direction. The another ray is reflected from the mirror in the same direction, in this direction. Okay. Now, what we have to put? We have to put here the eyepiece lens, and in such a way that the image is formed by this mirror here must be the focus point of this eyepiece. This is the intersection point of one parallel ray at the principal axis. So from here, make this line as the principal axis of eyepiece. So what we are going to do here, suppose this is our eyepiece lens. So we have to adjust this lens such that the focus of this lens must be here where the image is formed. So first I'm drawing the image is formed by this mirror. See here the image is A dash B dash. This is actual, the real image. That is why I'm saying this is A dash B dash and this is virtual image. So we can say this is A double dash and B double dash. This is our real image. That's why it is A dash B dash. The image object AB forms image A dash B dash. This object AB forms the real image A dash B dash. Suppose this mirror was not here, so AB would have been formed the image A dash A double dash B double dash. Actual image should be here, but due to this mirror, the final image by the intersection of the rays, the image is formed. So you can see the intersection is where? The intersection is here. So means this is the image of this object. So now we have to place what? The eyepiece lens here, such that the focus of the eyepiece must coincide here, so that the image will form at infinity. Let's draw that. See here, same way, this is the eyepiece. I'm just drawing the aperture, not the complete ray. Outline will be drawn at the last. So this is our eyepiece lens, you can say simply E. Now what will happen? The ray will bend toward the principal axis. Let's draw. And one more thing, this lens is adjusted such that this point is now focus of the eyepiece, means F, this is E. So this is FE. So if the object is at focus, so where the image will be formed? At infinity. Let's draw. So in which direction they will be turned and they will become parallel? So this ray, which is passing from the optical center, this is the virtual line. This will give the direction of parallel rays. So in this direction, these two rays will become parallel in this real, and in this direction virtual. Let's draw. So now what you can see, this object forms the image here. This image is placed at the focus of this eyepiece. So the rays are going parallel, and we will see this image, the infinite image, magnified image at infinity from this side. Let's draw the eye. So now you can see this image from this side when you will see. So how to perform this? This will be, this object will be celestial object. This will be at some very high position, so it can receive the rays, and reflected ray will be further received at the ground floor, means at the bottom, wherever you are standing, you can see from this side the magnified image of this celestial object. Now next point, that what will be the magnifying power and how to calculate its magnifying power. For that, the rule is, the magnifying power says, the rule is M magnifying power is equal to beta upon alpha. And I always say this angles are small, so small, the aperture is so small. So angle beta is equal to tan beta upon tan alpha. And what is beta and alpha? The visual angles. Alpha, I'm talking about first alpha. What is alpha? Alpha is the visual angle without any instrument. If you are seeing any object, whatever the angle is found at your eye is the alpha. So this is the object, and without instrument you can see from here. So this will be what? Your alpha. And this ray is coming to the pole of this mirror. So at pole, the rays are coming at which angle? The same angle they are reflected, means this angle is again alpha. So we can, let's a little bit clear it, this alpha. So in this triangle A double dash B double dash P, we can calculate tan alpha. Now what about beta? Beta with instrument. So here, what is the instrument? Instrument is the eyepiece. I missed to draw the outline. Let's draw first outline. Now you can see the eyepiece. I missed to draw this. Now alpha is done. Now this time for beta. Beta means with instrument to see the image. This is for object and this is for image. Object we have calculated alpha, and for the image, this is the image. For this image is here, you will say what? This is beta angle. So here I think in the triangle E A dash B dash we can also find the tan beta. So starting with the tan beta first, so tan beta is equal to perpendicular upon base A dash B dash upon F E, the focal length of eyepiece. See here, this is at focus. So this length, complete length, will be what? The focal length of the eyepiece. So I'm writing here for the tan beta that A dash B dash upon F E, you know why? This is at focus, divided by tan alpha. Tan alpha in this triangle, you can see tan alpha is equal to perpendicular A double dash B double dash upon, again this is what? At focus they are forming, they are, the rays are coming parallel, so the image will be formed at focus. So this is what? Focal length of this mirror. So again, what you will write? A double dash B double dash perpendicular divided by base, that is focal length of the objective. See here, FE, sorry, FO. So this is the denominator will go to the numerator. But one more thing, this is the image of this object, this is the image first, and this is due to the mirror. This is the reflected ray, this is virtual but this is real. You know that in the mirror and in front of the mirror, suppose you are standing in front of the plane mirror, so the image and object both are having same size. When you are stand to see your face in the mirror, you'll see the same size of the face. Same way, the A dash B dash and A double dash B dash double dash will be of same height. So if you are not understanding, again understand, this height and this height will be same, because in front of mirror, whatever the size of the object, inside the mirror the same image is formed, so they will be of equal size, so they will be cancelled. I'm writing here A dash B dash is equal to A double dash B double dash. Why? Again I'm saying, due to this mirror. In the plane mirror, the object size and the image size remains same. Now what will happen? M is equal to this A double dash B double dash will be cancelled, the FO will be on the top, and this will be FE. Now what about the sign convention? You have to calculate. You can see this one is on the right side. What is that? FO. So it will be positive. But for this lens, the focus of means eyepiece is on the left side. So this will be negative. That is why M is equal to minus FO upon FE. This is same as you have seen in the refracting type. Here you are seeing reflecting type. Both are having the magnifying power equation same. Okay. Still see the clear image. Okay.
So what you have seen, the magnifying power of astronomical telescope is M is equal to minus FO upon FE, means focal length of objective to the focal length of eyepiece. This is same for the refracting type and reflecting type. For both of them, the expression is remaining same. So the advantages of this reflecting type telescope in comparison to refracting type telescope, I have explained you. First point, that the reflecting type telescope means if you are using the concave mirror, so this telescope will be free from chromatic and the spherical aberration. Second point is the image formed by the reflecting type telescope, means if you are using the mirror, spherical mirror, so the image will be brighter than if you are using only lenses. This point also I have explained. This is quite difficult to draw a large aperture of lens, and we can manufacture easily the large aperture of mirror, and the high resolution of image will be obtained using this reflecting type telescope. So now after this, I'm ending this session, and I'm summing up this lecture on this topic right here. In the next lecture, I will do solve the numericals. So if you want that your numerical should be solved, so inform me, else I will solve by my own. So till then, be safe, take care, thank you.